In this video, we will discuss about the structure of human egg, and then we will see various types of eggs which are produced in different animals. So, structure of human egg, or which is also known as the ova. Human egg is a small cell. The size is normally 0.1 millimeter. And it is a rounded cell, round structure. So if we draw the cell, it is round and it has its own plasma membrane. This plasma membrane of egg is known as the vitelline membrane. Plasma membrane or vitelline membrane. This membrane is secreted by the cell itself. Secreted by the cell, and on the basis of this, the terms are given, like the membrane which is secreted by the cell is called primary, then we have secondary membranes and tertiary. So this would be considered as the primary membrane, that is plasma membrane or the vitelline membrane. The cytoplasmic content is divided into two parts. The outer one is known as the egg cortex. And this is less dense, egg cortex, or it is also known as exoplasm. The inner one, where most of the organelles are there, nucleus is also there, that inner part is known as the ooplasm. So this inner one is ooplasm, and ooplasm has nucleus and all organelle, as well as it has the nutritive material, that is yolk. In case of human egg, the yolk content is very, very less. So we'll write very, very less yolk content. And the nucleus is present. The nucleus is eccentric. It is a bulging nucleus. It is eccentric, means it is not in the center of the egg. It is on one side. This nucleus is known as germinal vesicle. Now, because of this eccentric position of the nucleus, the egg has polarity. That means one side where the nucleus is and there would be an opposite pole. So the side where this nucleus is, this side is known as the animal pole. The entry of sperm into the egg always takes place through this animal pole, and the opposite end would be termed as the vegetal pole. And that is why the egg has polarity. That is, one side where the nucleus is, that will be termed as animal pole, and the opposite will be termed as the vegetal pole. Outside this vitelline membrane, there is a non-cellular layer. This non-cellular layer is secreted by the follicular cells. And that is why it is also known as jelly membrane, because there are no cells. This is zona pellucida. And zona pellucida is secreted by the follicular cells. By follicular cells. And now the third layer. The third layer is actually made up of the follicles themselves. And these follicles, they are arranged in such a manner that they appear radiating. These are the follicular cells. And the arrangement is such that they appear radiating from the outer side. And that is why this membrane is known as corona radiata. So these are the follicular cells, and the layer is called corona radiata. Corona radiata is made up of the follicular cells. So, one layer is secreted by the cell itself, second layer is secreted by the follicular cells, and the third is actually made up of follicular cells. So when we draw this corona radiata, it appears as if the cells are radiating from the central part going towards the outer side. So I've drawn some places where we are seeing this corona radiata, but it's going to be everywhere. So these are all the corona radiata follicular cells. So in case of human egg, the cytoplasm is divided into two zones, the complete organelle and little bit of yolk, whatever is present in the central part of the cytoplasm. The nucleus is shifted on one side, and this is a haploid cell. This is the female gamete. On the basis of from where the membranes have arise, we divide these membranes into three categories: the egg envelopes or the egg membranes. They arise from different structures. So, first category, primary membrane. Primary membranes are the ones which are secreted by the cell. So they are secreted by cell. The example that we will take here is vitelline membrane. So vitelline membrane is the primary membrane of the egg. Second category, secondary membranes. Secondary membranes are secreted by the follicular cells. By follicular cells. Or they are made up of follicular cells. So here the example that we take is of zona pellucida and corona radiata. One is secreted by follicles and the second is made up of follicles. The third category, those membranes are called tertiary membranes. And tertiary membranes are the ones which are secreted by certain glands. Secreted by glands, especially in the oviduct part. And the example that we would take here is of the shell. Now, we see many eggs which have shell around them. So, shell is secreted by a gland called shell gland, which is towards the end of the oviduct, and that is an outer protective layer. So, this is how these egg membranes or egg envelopes are classified. Primary, secreted by the cell. Secondary, secreted or made up of follicular cells, and tertiary, secreted by certain glands which are located in the oviduct. In case of human egg, the yolk content is very less. Such eggs are known as microlecithal eggs. So, microlecithal word is used for the quantity that they have, and the quantity is negligible, very, very less. Now, in some other animals, for yolk synthesis, special type of chromosomes, which are known as lamb brush chromosomes, appear, which help in yolk synthesis. So, this is not seen in case of human beings. Lamb brush chromosomes, they appear in lower vertebrates, and the role of these chromosomes is to increase the yolk synthesis. So this is a feature which is found in other organisms, not in case of human beings. So the structure, spherical, two poles, and the term is given on the basis of the location of nucleus. The side where the nucleus is called the animal pole, and the significance is that entry of sperm would take place through animal pole. Plus, the first cytokinesis would also be on the same plane when the zygote divides after fertilization. The first zygotic division would also be on the same plane. but the entry is going to be from the animal pole. And the reason why this entry has to be from animal pole, because as soon as the sperm enters, its nucleus, which brings half the number of chromosomes, should fuse with the chromosomes which are present in the egg of the ovum, so that this fusion takes place as soon as the sperm enters. And that is why the entry is from here. Now, in the next part, we would talk about different types of eggs which are seen in different animals.